In today's video, I will be reading a story in Bulgarian and then translating it to English for you. It's from the first book of a six-book series called Patilanci by Ran Busilek, and the first book is Patilantro, which is also the name of our main character. Patilantro has something to do with mischief in the word etymology, and then he's actually writing letters to his friend Smehurko, which kind of relates to laughter, about his mischief over the summer and his working for Baba Cuculana, which is Grandma Cuculana, and she's a big lady, so she has that name. So I will start by reading the very first letter from the series, and you will get to know all about his first story working for Baba Cuculana.
Баба Цоцолана. Драги ми Смехурко, бързам да ти пиша. Но как да захвана? Ще почна направо с баба Цоцолана. Ех, да знаеш само колко е припряна, но аз се не стреснах, прислужник и станах. Чух край мен да казват, горкото момченце има да си паци. Той не знае, че баба честичко налага. Но и те не знаят, че мен Патиланчо ме дигат и слагат. Не знам по-нататък, що има да става, но моята баба страх ми не внушава. Тя лесно се сърди, ала пък и лесно гневът ти минава. Кресливичка пада, но не се преструва. А за мен, Смехурко, това много струва. Що трябва да правя, всякога ще зная. Тя самичка, вчера си каза каква е. Патилане, рече, ти трябва да знаеш, че аз съм припряна. Нищо, бабо, нищо, зато и пък аз нося сърчице за смяна. После, Патилане, моята ръчичка възтежичка пада. Та ако те нявга така поналожа, нищо, бабо, нищо, то без той не може. Добре се разбрахме. После моята баба две стомни донесе и така ми рече. Е там на Мегдана, от тук недалече, за вода ще идеш. Чешмата ще видиш. Тъй обичаят. По водата тръгне от сега до края. Зная, баба, зная. И аз се завтекох с шарените стомни. Тичах да се върна, да бърз и послушен, баба да ме помни. Ала, нали има глава да си паци? Без да ме съгледа, колелото блъсна в мен съседа страти. Той литна горкият, нагоре с нозете. Ала и аз щупих стомните и двете, но стисках им здраво дръжките в ръцете. Ни жив, нито мъртъв, при баба се върнах. Счупените дръжки отдалеч тя зърна. Ех, че като викна баба Цоцолана, абре, Пацилане, с това ли захвана? Жив не ще останеш, ако те подхвана. Но аз си разказах как белята стана. И лесно и мина. Кой, страци ли? Рече. Зная го аз него. Той три пъти вече как тая година и мене събаря. Не можа ли барем там да се прибие? Ох, стига му, бабо, сега на чешмата раните си мие. Така му се пада. Вчера ще да смажа съседката Рада, но той още днеска стомните ще купи. А ти тичай. С бялото менче иди на чешмата. С него и да паднеш, няма да се счупи. С бялото менче донесох водица. Всичко се заглади. И аз не опитах как лекичко милва на моята баба тежката ръчица. Чакай второ писмо, драги ми Смехурко. Поздрав най-сърдечен. Твой приятел вечен, весел Патиланчо.
My dear Смехурко, I'm eager to write to you, but where do I start? I will begin with Grandma Cuculana. Ah, know that she's very harsh. But I wasn't scared. I became her servant. I heard people say around me, poor boy, he'll suffer. He doesn't know that grandma frequently disciplines.
But even they don't know that I put cilantro and picked up and put down. I don't know what will happen after that. But my grandma doesn't scare me. She is easily offended, but then again, her rage easily passes. She shouts a lot, but she doesn't pretend. For me, Smihurko, this is valuable. I will always know what I have to do. Yesterday, she herself told me how she is. But Ilane, she said, you have to know that I am rash. Never mind, Grandma, never mind. This is why my heart is joyful. Later, Patilane, my hand falls heavily, so if I ever start to use it like this, never mind, Grandma, never mind. We can't do without it. We have understood each other well. Later, my grandma brought two pitchers and said, over there in the square, not too far from here, is where you'll go for water. You'll see the fountain. That's tradition. Let it run smoothly from now to the end. I know, Grandma, I know. And I went with the colorful pitchers. I ran on the way back, so the Grandma can remember me as quick and obedient. But there's trouble in everything. Without seeing me, Strati the neighbor hit me with his bike. He flew the poor guy up with his feet, and I broke the pitchers, both of them. But I tightly gripped their handles. Neither alive nor dead, I went back to Grandma. She saw the broken handles from far away. Ah, when Grandma Tsutsulana started to scream, well, Patilane, is this how you start? You won't stay alive if I get you. But I told her how the trouble happened, and she easily calmed down. Who, Strati? She said, I know him. He's done it to me 3 times this year already. Couldn't he at least die there? Oh, enough, Grandma. He's cleaning his wounds at the fountain now. Serves him right. Yesterday he was about to run over our neighbor, Rada. But he will buy the pitchers today. You run. Go to the fountain with the white jug. Even if you fall with it, it won't break. I brought water in the white jug. Everything was all right again. And I didn't get to feel Grandma's heavy hand. Await a second letter, my dear Smihurko. Sincerest greetings, your friend forever, Vesel Patilantro.